art is an expression of three visual systems. There is the artistic vision, which is stylistic and highly intimate. There is the inward vision, which is in the mind's eye of the artist. Then there is the ocular vision, which is how you actually see the world around you. This is extremely altered by any physical problems you may have with your eyes. I'm an ophthalmologist, and I've been in Richmond for many years. Through my education and the grace of God, I have the opportunity to help restore vision to many individuals and to aid people with visual diseases so they can cope with the disease and hopefully turn it into an asset in exploring different avenues of their life. Along with Mr. Gosses, there are many artists that have been influenced by visual handicaps in their artwork. Artists like Monet, Renoir, O'Keeffe, El Greco, just to mention a few. Many have been successful in overcoming their handicaps and expressing it in ways that have left a mark in the industry. The feat in itself is miraculous. The results are inspiring. What inspires them begs the question of what inspires any of us. Ron Gosses is a three-dimensional abstractionist who begins his textual masterpieces with two-dimensional surface and turns it into something magnificent and truly amazing. His visual handicap occurred because of a childhood injury, but through creativity, texture, color, imagination, his artwork transforms itself from static form to a sculpture on canvas. His art seems to elicit an involuntary urge to touch. When you view his work, you have to be amazed and in awe by the man behind these accomplishments.
At the young age of 5, Ronald was fencing with a neighborhood child using the long, dry stems of daylilies. It was great fun because the stems made a terrific whooshing sound when slashed through the air. The playful romp came to an abrupt end when his friend accidentally scratched the retina of Ronald's left eye. For 18 months, Gosses had to wear an eye patch, switching back and forth from eye to eye. Afterwards, the world as he saw it was flat, without airspace. His art from that point on reflected the still life world that he lived in.
Keep away from people who try to belittle your ambitions. Small people always do that, but the really great ones make you feel that you too can become great. Mark Twain.
When Ronald was 8, he experienced art censorship for the first time. His teacher instructed the class to draw something beautiful. Ronald drew a picture of Mae West, complete with all of her obvious physical attributes.
Oh, it's better to be looked over than overlooked.
The teacher was very upset, tearing the picture to pieces, and sent Ronald to the office. The principal contacted Ronald's parents, who, being artists themselves, naturally argued in his defense. Watching it all, Ronald was amazed at how powerful and polarizing a simple drawing could be. From then on, art was his constant companion.
To create one's own world takes courage. Georgia O'Keeffe.
In his 20s, Ronald worked in display at local department stores. Luckily, his vision problem did not affect his career, and he stayed in retailing to become a corporate executive vice president at two major department stores in the United States and Canada. Gosses developed all aspects of store design, visual merchandising, fashion, and graphics. He traveled extensively in Europe and Asia, designing furniture and clothing, and worked with famous design houses, including Oleg Cassini, Tommy Hilfiger, Nolan Miller, and Pucci International. In 2008, Ronald's eye doctor explained that his vision was changing and that his injured eye might be able to see dimension and depth again. When it first happened, Ronald had to grab hold of a chair to keep from falling because the room around him suddenly seemed to be moving. Ronald was actually able to see air, space, and depth for the first time in over 50 years. He was exhilarated and driven to express his new gift of visual dimension on canvas. Ronald added fabric in a bold juxtaposition of vivid colors and texture. His paintings became more abstract, and he used many other materials, creating even greater visual contrast. This mixed media triptych from 2009 entitled Journey into Dementia, Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow depicts the changes within a brain affected with Alzheimer's. It was inspired by Ronald's father who died of the disease, and it now hangs in the Alzheimer's Association headquarters in Louisville, Kentucky. Ronald's latest series, Art in 3D, has been described as sculpture on canvas. While each piece exhibits well as is, when seen through special glasses, its multi-layered dimensions are greatly enhanced. Ronald's art has exhibited at the Seoul National Gallery in South Korea, the Netherlands, and Switzerland. It has also shown in New York City and across the United States. His work has been featured in many newspaper articles, art books, catalogs, and magazines. Most recently, he was on the cover of and was the featured artist in the 2014 fall edition of Art Voices magazine. Ronald is a passionate member of the arts community, and he actively mentors young emerging artists. He feels that many artists graduate from college with great creative skills, yet have no idea about marketing their art. Years of sales experience enables Ronald to help people find place for their art in the non-academic world.
Be yourself and create what you want to create. Ignore those who say what you do is not art, certainly not good art. Keep working at it and be true to yourself. Eventually, the world will catch on.